Hi, this is Elena with Black Sheep 303 Creative, and my project today is for the Elizabeth Craft Designs Designers Challenge for the month of November 2017, which is to create a pop-up card using the cool new General Pop-Ups dies. And I have combined several stamp sets in this card, so the video is a little bit long because there's a fair amount of coloring and then a fair amount of construction, so hopefully you'll bear with me. So on the left there is the Snowman and Gifts stamp set, in the center is Reindeer and Birds, and then on the right is the Holiday Trees and Ornaments stamp set. And I'm going to be stamping one or two stamps from each of these in Memento Tuxedo Black ink onto some 85-pound soft finish white cardstock. Now you only need to stamp the holiday or the bird garland once. I thought I was going to use it more than what I did wind up using it for. So if you do want to replicate this card, you only need one of those bird garlands. But hey, I got to practice a bunch of times coloring it, so that was good. Now I'm going to be coloring with my Spectrum Noir markers, which are alcohol ink based markers. I really like them and I use them quite frequently. And to start off with, I'm going to be using blue turquoise for my bird. So I'm starting with the darkest shade, which is BT5. And I'm just adding a little bit of shadows on the base of the tail, under the wing, and then kind of right along the breast. And then I'm going to take BT4, which is the next lightest shade, I guess would be the correct way to say that. I don't know. And I'm blending that out a little bit. And then I'm going to take my BT2, which is the lightest shade, and blend the entire thing out. And the BT2 is quite light. So after I had blended the whole thing, as you'll see here in a second, I didn't really like how light it was. So I went back with BT4 and darkened down a lot of the bird and just used a little bit of the BT2 here and there to add more like a highlight rather than making it the majority of the color of the bird. And then for my wing, I wanted that to be darker. So I'm taking BT5 and just kind of dotting it sort of right under the little wing details that are part of the stamp. And then I'm blending it with BT2, but that's too light. So I come back with the BT4 really and just darken it down more than the actual bird body. So we get like a darker wing effect. Now there is some bleeding with this, and this is CT4 for the beak, sorry. There's a little bit of bleeding with soft finish cardstock because you have to saturate the paper pretty thoroughly with alcohol inks, but I just take a white glaze pen and I clean up the edges of my stamps and it works perfectly. And if you've watched any of my other videos, you know about this. This is my favorite trick, but I highly endorse it and it works like a charm. Now my greens are a combination of CG2, DG2, and DG3. I kind of base coated with DG2. I added a little shading with CG2, and then I take the tip of the CG2 to the DG3 to add some shading. And my berries are CR11 as the base coat with a little bit of shading with DR5, and then I blend that a tiny bit with the CR11. Now my tree is going to be the same green. So here I'm starting off with DG2, and I'm just kind of randomly coloring it around. And then I'm going to take the CG2, which is close to DG2, a little bit darker, and add that like sort of under some of the stars and around in different areas. And then I'm going to take the DG3, which is much darker than both of these, and I'm going to really start like kind of just scribbling it. I added it under the snow for like extra shading, and then I'm scribbling it around a little bit to create texture on the tree. And now I'm taking the tip of my CG2 to the tip of the DG3, and I'm coloring with the CG2 marker after I've touched the DG3 to get like a middle shade between those two colors that helps tone down all those hash marks that I made with the DG3. But you still see those hash marks a little bit, which helps kind of create the illusion of texture, like branches on the tree. I do this a lot with fur on animals too. It's something, I just like texture. What can I say? Okay, so now I'm adding my accent colors, which are again the turquoise, the red, and the yellow, or the yellowy gold. So BT4 I'm adding to some of the stars. I did add some BT2 to that star or to the tree topper, but I will change that later. And then here's DR5 going on some of the different stars. And then finally, I will add CT4 to the remaining stars. And then I'm going to color the trunk with TN7. which you kind of saw very briefly there, and I'm sparkling up my snow with the Spectrum Noir Clear Sparkle Marker. And then here's where I'm changing the star out to CT4. Now for my birds, I base coated with CT2, and then I'm shading with CT4 and blending now with CT2. The birds are very, very bright. So I will tone them down a little bit later. But I did do the package in the back with CT2, and it has some dots on it. And then my front package is going to be the blue turquoise. So I'm starting with BT4. I'm going to add a little bit of shading with the BT5. Oh, and then also on the dots in that back package. And then, oh, this is still BT4. Sorry. Now here's my BT5 with some shadows around the bow and sort of like the sides of the package and that ribbon on the middle package, I guess it is. And now I'm blending that with the BT4 to kind of get a nice blend between the darkness of the BT5 and the mid-tone of the BT4. And then I'm blending that all back with the BT2. And then I decide that ribbon in the back's a little bit too light, so I add more BT5 to it, blend again with the BT4, add a little more BT5, blend again with the BT4, so that looks a little bit darker, and it looks like it's behind that front package. And then for my bow, I did the green. So it's the CG2 tip to the DG3 for that medium shade on the stripes. And then I'm going to color the bow itself with the CG2 and then add shading with the DG3. So no blending on those two, just used them separately. And then I'm going to do that blended tip-to-tip method again for the tree in the back. So CG2 touching the DG3 tip and then coloring with the CG2 marker. And then my red accent is going to be DR5 on the packages. I did use CR11 for the hearts that the birds are holding to separate them a little bit. And I do get some bleeding here, so I will take my white glaze pen and clean that up. You won't see me do it, but I do that. And now I'm sparkling my yellow stars up with the Stardust Gold Jelly Roll pen. And then here I'm going to tone maybe I'm going to color my tree trunk. That's TN7 for the tree trunk, same as the first tree. And then I'm toning my birds down a little bit. I added a tiny bit of CR10, which is an orangey tone. And now I'm blending it with the CT2. And then I will add a little more blending with the CT4 just to get the birds a little less vibrant. Now, I wanted some candy cane stripe paper for the front of my card, but I didn't have any, so I decided to create my own with double-sided adhesive tape and glitter. So this is 6mm double-sided adhesive tape from Elizabeth Craft Designs, and I'm just eyeballing a diagonal placement on this piece of 85-pound soft finished cardstock that is cut to 3.5 by 2.75. Oh, no, I'm sorry. It is 4.25 by 3.5. I'm getting my papers confused. So 4.25 by 3.5. And then you just trim off the excess tape and then pour true red silk microfine glitter over it and then burnish it down. So just rub it with your finger. And then same for the second half. And then you just wipe it off with a brush and put your glitter back in your container and you are good to go there. Now on the inside, I have die cut out my colored images with the matching dies, and that's what's going to go on my die, or my pop-up. So this is the general pop-up's dies. You can see how many options there are, a million. So I'm going to use the two-step. It's got two steps to it, like there's a lower step and an upper step. And I'm lining up those nubs with the center fold, and this is an A2 size top folding card base with the out of 85-pound soft finished cardstock, and it's got the texture facing in, so you will see the texture when you open the card. So I'm lining up the nubs with the fold, and I'm going to run it through my die cutter. So it's been through the die cutter now, and I'm just peeling off the paper tape to remove the die, and you'll see it will have cut and scored for the pop-up mechanism. So I'm pushing it in, at least the lower step in. Then I'm going to take my tweezers and push the upper step in and then fold it closed to get that pop-up mechanism trained real well. And that's all it takes. Super easy. Those dies make, and there's like 20 choices, I don't know, 10 choices probably on those die sets. So really cool. So my tree's going to go on the top and the packages are going to go on the lower step. So I'm putting a little piece of 6mm double-sided adhesive tape, which is just exactly the right size for that, the front of that upper step. And I'm going to adhere the tree a little bit off to the left. And then my presents are going to the right. So I'm putting tape on the upper right of the step, lower step, and then the back of the bird stamp too. Now I have trimmed my tree trunk mostly off because I wanted to, you need to clear the fold where the step is. You see there, that little fold, you need to make sure you're above that when you put your image in there. And then same on the lower step. So you need to make sure it's above the fold line, just a little bit, right there, when you adhere it down. And then when you fold it closed, it will work like a charm and then pop up when you open the card. And it will look like that. So super cute and really easy. That die set makes it so simple. Okay, so to assemble the inside, you're gonna need that black chain that is cut from that Jewels 1 die set, it's the middle die there, out of some black, rich black soft finish cardstock. I've got glitter dots. I've got a matching piece of glitter card to the striped peppermint paper from the front. So I made it exactly the same way that I made the peppermint paper, except I used an adhesive sheet rather than the tape for that. And now I'm just adhering that Jewels die piece, the black piece, down with some Zig to a glue pen. And then this is the bird garland, so the single bird garland that I used, that I've die cut out with the matching die, and I'm adhering this to the top border of the inside of the card. And so that glitter paper there is cut to 3 inches by 1 7/8 inches. And that greeting piece is 85 pound soft finish cardstock that's cut to 2 3/4 by 1 5/8. So I'm adhering those together. And that Merry Christmas I stamped with some detail black ink. And that is from the Christmas collection clear stamps, which is very pretty Christmas greetings. And I'm going to adhere that to the inside middle of the inside of the car and then just trim off the excess of that Jewels die. And for some accent, I'm using my red and gold glitter dots, which come in, I don't know, 4 or 5 sizes on one sheet. And so I'm using a couple different sizes and I'm adding 3 of them sort of randomly to that little Jewels die. So a couple to the inside of the open circles, then one to the center of one of the closed circles. And that completes the inside. So here's your outside of your card. You need 2 more of those black Jewels dies that you see there. And then you're going to need an A2 size top folding card base that I have cut from regular cardstock. So it does not have the texture. I did that on purpose because I wanted to contrast with the texture of the soft finish cardstock, which is this piece, which this is cut to 3.5 by 2 3/4. And I stamped the greeting on that from the holiday cheer stamps in that same detail black ink. And I'm going to adhere that onto this piece of pattern paper from the Moda Scrap It's Time for Christmas 6x6 paper pack, which is cut to 3 3/4 by 3 inches. And then we're going to adhere all of this down, pardon my jingling dog, with some 6mm adhesive tape into the center of our candy cane striped paper that we made earlier with the glitter. And as I mentioned then, that paper was cut to 4 1/4 by 3.5. And now I'm going to put some 3mm adhesive on the top and the bottom edges. And I'm taking 2 pieces of olive twist soft finish cardstock that are cut to about, it's 4 1/4 by about 1/4 inch. And then I'm adhering it to the backside, giving it about 1/8 inch border on the top and the bottom of that candy cane panel. And then I'm just going to adhere that entire piece with 6mm double-sided adhesive tape all the way right in the center of that A2 size top folding card base. And it really makes a nice contrast between the plain pattern, the plain white card base, and the beautiful texture of the soft finish cardstock that's both on the white and that olive color. Like, it's really, really pretty. And then I just trimmed off a little bit of the extra olive that was hanging over. And then my birds, I'm adhering down, web die cut out with the matching dies again, and then I'm adhering down with some Zig 2A glue pen right into the center above the greeting for the focal point, basically, of the front of the card. So my little bluebirds there. And then I'm going to take the two jewels dies, and same as we did on the inside of the card panel, I'm using some Zigdewy glue pen to adhere this to the top and bottom white borders there. So I'm going to do it just like I did there for the top. And then we're going to take the red and gold glitter dots again and add those to both of these borders. So some on the inside of those open holes, as you see there, and then some in the centers of the black dots here and there. And I will add four to the outside of the top and the bottom, whereas I did three on the inside, just so you know. And so that will complete the outside of the card. Once you trim off the excess of the die, the little border dies that are hanging over on either side. And my husband is practicing guitar, so I'm glad that everyone's decided to make noise while I'm doing my voiceover. All right, anyway. To adhere the two pieces together, I put 10 millimeter double-sided adhesive tape on the outside of the inside piece of the card. So I'm butting this up to the fold in the outer piece, and I'm going to just fold it shut to adhere the two pieces together. And then you just flip it over and do the exact same thing on the back side, so that then you'll have your completed card. And inevitably when you do this, you're always going to have some overhang. So there's going to be some parts that you're going to have to trim off. They just don't line up perfectly, I think, because they're the same size. So you'll just have to trim it the edges clean, and then that is your completed card. And even though there were a lot of steps, I know, it is very, very cute and pretty easy to put together. So believe it or not, and especially with the pop-up dies, makes the pop-up mechanism super easy to do. And so you could do that for virtually anything with those dies. But I hope I've given you a little inspiration to try out a pop-up die this holiday season. Thanks so much for watching. Supplies are linked in the video description and over on my blog. And please check out the Elizabeth Craft Designs blog post, which is linked in the video description as well, for the other designers' projects. Have a great day!